Thank you. Our third witness is Bruce Rastetter, who is the Chief Executive Officer of Hawkeye Renewables and serves on the Board of Directors of the Renewable Fuels Association. Prior to joining Hawkeye Renewables, Mr. Rastetter was founder and CEO of Heartland Pork. Hawkeye Renewables operates two ethanol plants in Iowa with a combined capacity for producing 215 million gallons of ethanol annually. And on my last trip back to the district, I had the pleasure of getting a tour of one of the facilities in Hawkeye, Iowa from Mr. Rastetter. Welcome.
Well, good morning, Mr. Chairman and Congressman Davis. I really appreciate the opportunity to be here today. And certainly growing up on a small farm in rural Iowa and being encouraged to get a good education and being able then to come back to agriculture and see a dynamic industry that continues to grow and offers both great opportunity and hope for our country in terms of energy and increased food production and all the benefits that are going to come with it. I certainly appreciate the opportunity to visit with you today about your initiative on education. As founder and CEO of Hawkeye, as you mentioned, today we currently have two plants, one in Iowa Falls and one in Fairbank. We're engaged in building two more 100 million gallon plants in Iowa. Each of those plants employs about 45 people. As an operator, I can absolutely tell you that there's no lack of demand or interest in renewable energy in terms of jobs and people's interest in this. As an example, when our Fairbank plant was set to open, we received over 800 applications for the 45 jobs. However, I can also tell you that it was easy to sift through those prospective hires based on the degree of education, training, or experience that the applicants had. In fact, of the 45 people per plant, on an average, only 7 to 10 had any degree of experience in biofuels. For the remaining employees, Hawkeye, like many other ethanol producers, have implemented wide-ranging comprehensive training programs for each plant. At Hawkeye, we partnered with our technology provider to implement that training, and education is part of bringing those employees on and teaching them some basic skills of biofuels. Moving forward, this is an exciting industry to be involved with, and frankly, being located in America's heartland, there's a great degree of hope and excitement about the quality of jobs being offered, as well as the overall effect of contributing to our national economy and energy security. As with any growing industry, the biofuels industry faces a number of issues related to its continued and sustained growth. One of the most important challenges is the access to a quality workforce that is educated and trained to work in the biofuel space. That's why I'm pleased to be with you today, Congressman Braley, to discuss your initiative on training and to help bolster the education process at community colleges in Iowa and across the country. Across the country, biofuels plants have sought to build collaborative relationships with educational institutions at all levels, be it in research and development with research universities or in training and education with community colleges like we are discussing today. The relationships between these that are active and operational in the industry with those in the educational community will provide long-lasting positive effects in our communities. It is also noteworthy, I think, to remember that this industry is still relatively new and is undergoing massive growth. Because of that, there is an incredible amount of work to be done in research and development with biofuels, but also that research and development will no doubt lead to more and better jobs as well. This industry will continue to grow through the use and development of additional technologies, and that will require additional education and training to ensure there's a prepared workforce for these jobs that will come online. A friend of mine reminded me of what happened in the oil industry years ago in Texas in that part of our country. Because of the new discoveries, the new jobs, and the new technologies that continue to develop, many educational institutions invested in training and education for jobs related and research related to that industry. While the country has to continue to look for oil elsewhere today, people from around the world come to learn from the very best about the oil production discovery space here in America. The center of intellect and potential for renewable and alternative energy should be in America. And I would further argue that it makes sense for that to be located in the Midwest. And with encouraging pieces of legislation like this bill, we can continue to move toward real potential as a reality of part of this industry. Hawkeye has a great relationship with our local community college in Ellsworth Community College in Iowa Falls. Today with me is Molly Teckenberg, the provost of Ellsworth. One of the initiatives community colleges are taking around this country is to look forward and to pass bond issues. Ellsworth did one last fall to fund a renewable center. Your bill is very timely in terms of additional funding towards training and education and outreach to high schools and other parts of the community to bring those people to have interest in continuing to move forward with renewable energy and to match programs the communities are investing in rural America today and going forward. Thank you for your time.